What's up, guys? Rick and I are out here practicing a little social distancing, trying to find some sheds. We kind of came across a cool spot here, though. Probably not a big buck bed location, but definitely a spot where deer used a fallen tree to get some cover in the wintertime. So you can see here this pine fell in the middle of this pine forest. And within that, this whole area is matted down up underneath the pine. You can see multiple beds. I mean, there's probably a dozen beds that are laid out all in here. And I can pretty easily see a family of doe bedded right up in this area. You've got a lot of poop that's congregated right in here, but the cool thing is they can bed in here. You can see all the tips of these pines are eaten off, so they're feeding on the tips of all these pines. Creates a good food source for them. The one small tree that's in here, this is the buds on this tree, and anything that's woody and green is all nibbled down. So it's just kind of a cool spot. I don't think it's a spot where you're gonna get a whole lot of bedding in here outside of the winter season, because we've got a marsh and swamp area that's to our north. And then this pine kind of comes up on a rise, but it's nice and dry in here. You've got a lot of water that's probably 50 yards from us, so it makes sense that they'd be up on this high ground. And even today we've got a pretty good southwest wind. So this is really protecting us from the wind as well. So it's kind of a cool spot. I mean,
I've been out here opening bull week and I've kicked a buck out of the pines right in here.
Yeah.
So in the beginning of the season they would be.
Yep. But yeah, if you're thinking about a late season hunt, you need to put some meat in the freezer. A situation like this, you know, again, you'd have to watch your access coming in here, but this is a good little, it's almost a cave that they're hanging out in here. It's a pretty cool little spot.
He was actually watching the trail over there. That's where he busted me.
Yeah. And you could from here, they've got a nice vantage point to sort of a heavy trail that's a transition of the swamp and these pines. And then there's an exit corridor that runs right through here.
Yep.
And wraps around where this tree fell down. But sitting in here, you can feel the wind coming to our backside, so it's kind of a cool little setup. They probably get some swirling in here, but they've got nice cover to their back. So, the infamous balloon. So what's sort of interesting about this is you've got a high spot behind us, and it descends down into a lower area, but we've got sort of a cluster of pines right here. And I can tell just by looking into that little cluster, the earth is pretty matted down underneath that big pine tree. And there's a lot of the branches that are broken off on the pine right at the base of the tree, as well as some more browse. And you can see right where the balloon is laying, ironically, there's a corridor that goes right over that other fallen down pine. So.
Yep.
I don't know what this tells you guys, if the balloon thing is a thing or not, based on where thermals travel. I think it might just, you know, we've got an open area in the sky, and yes, thermals would be dropping down this hillside or being pulled up. So this does create sort of a pooling area of wind and scent. But we have a bed. We have a bed right underneath it, so let's go check it out. So if you look here, this opens up a bit in here, but you can see all these saplings are nibbled off. So you've got multiple deer coming through this corridor and feeding, but I'm willing to bet it doesn't look like it was used recently, but this is a bed. This whole area here is matted down. You can see how the ground is really mat and worn out. Especially even up against the tree, you can see how some of that moss is worn off right at the base of the tree. So there's been a deer or multiple deer bedding right in here, and a lot of these branches are broken off in here. These are broken, and these buds are all nibbed off. So
I would say it was last season, not anything lately.
Yeah, not anything lately. I wouldn't think they'd be bedded this low with a heavy amount of snow either. It'd get pretty deep in here, but it was probably used last season.
Yeah, definitely.
And there was a balloon sitting in it. Again.
Think what you may.
Think what you may. Guys, we're out here scouting some more. We came across a little oak island that probably is 50 yards in diameter, and it is pretty much shaped in a circle. We've got one large oak tree and three other smaller satellite oak trees that are on this island. What drew our attention, it's pretty thick in here and overgrown with buckthorn, but there was a main trail that was coming in off the transition. We were walking a transition of the swamp and the pine grove, and I looked into here and saw that there was a heavy trail coming onto this island. So Rick and I took a little walk, and about 70 yards into the island, we came to this opening. And now literally this opening is 10 yards in diameter, 15 yards in diameter. But right in the center of it, we've got branches broken off like a licking branch, and we've got a large community scrape right here. We've also got rubs that are in here. And there is no less than 1, 2, 3, 4 trails that are coming in off the point. So this island is in the shape of a circle, but it kind of makes a dewdrop point that leads off into the swamp this way. And right on that dewdrop point, we walked over there, and you can see a heavy trail that's coming into this. Now, why are they coming in here? I mean, my assumption would be a food source. So right up above us, you've got a large oak tree. And then just behind that, you've got two other satellite oak trees. They're kind of hard to see because there's, again, quite a bit of buckthorn growing up underneath here. And now if Rick turns, if we look, there's not only this oak tree where the opening is, but right where it makes the dewdrop point, there's another oak tree right at the point of the island. So we're definitely getting deer coming to this small island. This is a tiny island, again, like I'm saying. It's probably at max 50 yards in diameter, but they're coming here to feed on these oaks. And obviously this is a community spot where a buck is signing. Okay, it's making, it's dropping scent off, and it's checking what other deer are coming into this area. So it's a pretty cool spot. Now, how are we set up on this? As I'm standing here right now, the wind that's blowing across us is coming from the southeast, right?
I believe so, yeah.
Yeah, so it's cutting across the island like this. Where we were walking on the transition trail in the pines is back to what would be our west. So I would come from that direction and enter on the back side of this island. And I would try to slide up. There's a couple ash trees that are back right on the edge that would allow me to shoot to this opening. But there's also one of those two oaks that I could get up in. It's not as open over there on the back side of the island. So I think the deer are definitely gonna come here first and stage, and then they're gonna move forward. If I get up in one of those oak trees, that's gonna allow me to shoot to this opening. It's also gonna allow me to shoot to that trail that comes off of the point and parallels the edge of this small island and the swamp transition. So that's the trail we came in on. There's a heavy trail that goes all along this transition and leads right out to the way that we came to the pines. So it's almost like a micro example of an oak island and how they can use these. Good stuff.
It is.
I don't know if we want to walk you guys over. We can walk you over and show you how this trail looks at the tip of it.
Sure, why not?
Yeah, let's walk through this way. We'll walk through this corridor. So you can see this is pretty overgrown with buckthorn, but all this is bitten off. The deer that are coming through here now, in the wintertime, they'll eat the buds off of all these small woody trees, which is mainly in this area right now is buckthorn. But you can see this trail parallels this small island, and it makes this sort of dewdrop point here. So again, you've got one trail coming in off of here, and that snakes through, and we've got another set of high ground that's beyond the swamp.
Mm-hmm.
But that snakes in back there, and all this in here where you see that red brush mixed into those trees. Unfortunately, with a lot of our dead ash that's happening everywhere, but that's potential bedding all in there. And then here is where these trails converge. This is the other heavy trail that runs right through here. Obviously a lot more water in here. This is beat down a lot heavier. And then if Rick wants to come over, he can film. This is the other parallel trail that runs along the edge, other side of this dewdrop point. So if you think about this in the shape of a dewdrop, and this is the point at the bottom, you've got a trail that's running along this face of the dewdrop and a trail that's running along this face, and the oaks are right in the center. So the trails go like this, and then they converge into the center of the island.
Beautiful.
So I want to be on the downwind side of that.
Yep.
Of that food source, so I can set up where they're coming in. And be great if there was a little less buckthorn in here, because it would be easier shooting. And
yeah.
But this is what we have to deal with, so yep. It's a good spot.